Aloha everyone, welcome to The Guru Is You, Hatha Yoga in the Vinyasa tradition. I'm your host, Paul Reynolds, and with us today we have our guest, Yogi, Gabby.
Hi Gabby.
Hi.
Gabby's going to help us go through a sequence today, a simple sequence. We've named it Dance of the Kneeling Yogi, which means we're going to be on our knees quite a bit today. So if you need to bring some more cushion to your knees, a blanket or a pad of some sort underneath your knees would probably be appropriate. And always remember that at any point in the practice, you're allowed to take yourself out and give yourself rest if you need. And make sure that you listen to your body as best you can, and note that if it doesn't seem right for you, don't go there. Great, thank you very much. So where I'd like to start out at today is in child's pose. So if we can come into child's pose, Gabby, appreciate it. Gabby's starting in a variation of the child's pose where the knees are wide. But what I'd like her to do is to lift up and bring knees together. Good. And the arms out, stretched in the extended child's pose version. And our tradition here in our practice is that we acknowledge our connection by acknowledging breath. So at this point, everyone would please find breath with your awareness. And I'll call in four energies to our practice today to sort of be witness to and to be our partners in creating what we have here today from an energetic standpoint, as we go through our physical practice. So on the first breath that we take together, right, it'll be as full as you can, and then as you exhale, your breath will be out through your mouth and it's sort of an exasperated sigh, like okay. So the first in-breath brings in the energy of new beginnings. Okay, we've all been practicing together for some time, but we acknowledge the fact that there are unlimited possibilities each time we do practice, right? So this first in-breath together acknowledges new beginnings. So take the breath in full, let the belly gently press in against the sides of the thighs, really fill to capacity, and then let it out of your mouth in a sigh. Good, excellent. Second in-breath now brings in an acknowledgement of healing. And the healing I'm asking for here is not so much about trying to fix something, right? We always come into our practices with, you know, my back is hurting, I've got a bad whatever, you know, you give it a name. But today it's about healing in the sense of everything is correct just as it is. It's here for our further evolving, our further education about who we are. So take a nice deep in-breath, acknowledge healing, and exhale. Good. Third energy that I'd like to introduce to us here is this aspect that we call intuitive wisdom. It's the knowledge that you were born with, okay? Not necessarily the one that you learned in school, not necessarily the one that you took in workshops or learned in workshops, but it's that energy that you were born, it's your gut feeling, right? And that's the one that I ask you to turn to when you're asking yourself this question, is this where I need to be at this particular point, right? So take a nice deep in-breath for intuition, let it out of your mouth in a sigh. And last but not least, is this energy that we call surrender, right? That ability to let go just to what is. And within that is that aspect of judgment that all of us have and all of us struggle with sometimes, whether it be self-judgment or judgment of others. So take your opportunity now to take your breath in and surrender the exhale. going to do now, and I'd like you all to do, coming out of the extended child's pose, is keeping your head on the floor or on your mat, slowly lift off your heels and roll over the top of your head, right? So you access your upper spine and the back of your neck, okay? Good, and then as you exhale, float back down to your heels. Good, use your hands as brakes so you don't go too far, especially these first couple. So we're gonna do this about 3 times here. Okay, so in-breath lifts you up and over the top of your head. Exhale releases you back to your heels. Okay, Gary, a couple more times on your own. In-breath and lift up. Exhale and lower down. Once more, in-breath. And exhale. Okay, now this last time you come up, go ahead and come up. Go over to your, what you feel is your max. You're really feeling the stretch there. Hold it there now. Good. And take 3 breaths. And see if you can imagine the breath going right into the back of the neck and expanding that area. Good. Good. There we go. Cool. All right, now straighten your arms and press your body into what we call tabletop position. Chakrapakasana. Good. Crown of the head extends forward now, nice long neck. We're going to travel down the spine a little bit with this. And the next movement is what we call the scapula push-up. So keeping our arms straight, Gabby's going to let the chest float down towards the floor until the scapula comes together. Mm-hmm. See? Okay, and then exhale, arch just the upper back, but keep the head in line with the shoulders. That's it. Good, once more, chest drops down, shoulder blades come together. Are you keeping the lower spine neutral, right? Just here. So we're really focusing attention right in that upper mid-spine area. Good, once more. Keep extending the crown of the head forward. Good, that's it. And again, and up. Good, and last one, and release down. Good, and come up. Okay, now we'll go towards the mid-back and mid-spine area. So we're going to do this in the variation of a twist. So on the next in-breath, Gab's going to take her left hand and point the fingertips towards the right in front of her chest. So left hand, there you go. As she finds her next exhale, the right hand will come through and underneath, and she'll move down to her right shoulder and the right side of her head. And we call this, right, threading the needle. Okay. So at the same time now, she's sort of energetically reaching her lower spine and her sacrum away, right? As she reaches through with her right hand and presses in with the left like she'd want to straighten it, but she can't, right? Just by the way that you're built anatomically. Good, so take a couple more breaths here. And then the next in-breath draws back to that starting position in tabletop for a moment. Arch the back into a cat arch just to bring things to equilibrium. Okay, and the next time, now we go the other side. The right hand comes in, fingertips left, and she threads the needle with the left and moves down. Good. Again, reaching back and breathing. Good. The next in-breath brings her back to tabletop position where she arches the back into the cat arch. Now come to neutral now, good. Crown of the head extends. Now come down to the sacrum, and there's that dog tilt cat arch movement that we make. So the tilting is by dropping the hips forward, pelvis drops down the other way. There you go, there's the dog tilt. Right, and then tuck, move in the opposite direction. So she's keeping upper spine, shoulders in neutral as she tilts and tucks. Okay, so just move back and forth a few more times just to start to bring a little bit of lubrication into the bottom part of the spine. Good, once more. Good. Excellent. All right, come to neutral again here, right? Now we're going to try little bit more of a lateral movement, right, in the spine, and a little bit of the spine. So from here, she's going to take the left rib cage and reach it out towards my hand out here, right? So reach, good. Then lift up to a cat arch position as she shifts back to central. Then extend the right ribs out to the right, then drop down to center. Then float them over to the left, lift up, then over right and down. So if she gets in a little bit more of a flow to this, right, there you go, right? You can see it's this undulation of the spine on a horizontal plane, right? Now go the other way. She'll go out right, come up, out left, down, and a few more times, and getting that aspect addressed. Back to neutral. Okay. Now, inversions are always a big part of a yoga practice, but what we'd like to do here is a very sort of safe inversion. We're not going to get into a headstand just as yet. So what I want Gabby to do is come down to her forearms, spread her fingers nice and wide, and touch the tips of her thumbs together. Okay. She's centered her elbows right underneath her shoulders. Good. She's pressing her forearms into the floor, so if I was to try to lift, she wouldn't let me. Good. So she's very firm here. So now I want her to turn her toes under and straighten her legs out, coming into a forearm, a beginning of a forearm balance. Now I'll just ask a little bit more to relax the head, let the neck get really soft. Yeah, she's doing a little yes and no down there to let that upper spine get lubricated some more. Now walk her feet forward just a little bit more, one at a time. So she's looking to line up her hips above her shoulders as much as you can. It almost feels sometimes when you get this way that you're going to flop over, right? But you won't, right? Allow the heels to relax, to start to open up the backs of the legs a little bit here. Take a few more breaths. Slowly walk the feet back about a step or two, and then gently drop down to your knees again. And extended child's pose to take the pressure off your shoulders now and relax here. Great. A couple more breaths. We'll try one more round, right, of this beginning of the forearm balance. So Gabby will widen her fingers once more. One of the nice little small points in this too is as you widen your fingers, feel the webs in between your fingers getting stretched, right? Because it's the extremities as well as the major muscle groups that make up your practice. It's the totality. Now she turns her toes under, straightens the legs, and once more lets the head swing free. Walks the feet forward. See if you can feel a little bit more that her hips are lined up above her shoulders. Heels relax and she breathes. And then once more, right, taking the pressure off the shoulders, she'll walk back a step, let the knees lower to the floor. Good, and extended child's pose once more. The next in-breath now lifts her up into the tabletop position once more. Good. And we'll work with a little bit of a balance effort here right now. So I want her to take and extend the right leg back and off the floor. Good. Now, from here, we want to work with nomenclature called external rotation and internal rotation. So when I asked her to externally rotate at the hip joint, she's going to face her pelvis towards the right as she extends out through the ball of the foot. Good, good. And now internal goes the opposite way as you turn inward. There you go. Good. So take a moment to about two or three of these internal and external rotations. Good. Now as you internally rotate and come to neutral, take another deep in-breath here. As you exhale, bring right knee to forehead, forehead to right knee, and arch the back up. Next position is to bring that knee to the floor about 3 inches in front of your left knee and sit back in the extended child's pose with that position. Okay, it's going to feel real awkward, and it's meant to, right? Not all of your practice is about this perfect balance that you're trying to achieve all the time. So this allows you to take a look at what aspects, right, and it may be in right hip or left hip here, maybe small in the back for Gabby, as to what's feeling a little bit off, not quite in balance or equal. But what we can do here is use now the fact that she's got the right foot, right knee in front of the left as her base point now. As she pulls herself up, right, she extends the left leg now and off the floor and back, while the right leg is her support. Now again, if you're finding yourself not quite in balance here, you can take that right foot and push it off to the right a little bit. There you go. And sometimes it helps you to feel a little bit more in balance. So once again, externally rotate the left foot as you press out to the ball. Internally right, good. Or left, I should say. Externally and open. Internal and close, good. And once more. Now as she internally rotates, this left knee is going to come to her forehead once again as she arches her back, bring forehead to knee, knee to forehead. And now left knee moves to the floor in front of right, and she sits back, right, in the extended child's pose. Perfect. Take a couple breaths here. Notice where you're feeling. Feeling awkward? Great. If you do feel unawkward, everything seems to be, you've got pretty open hips and an open small in your back. And that's fine too. Okay. All right, now her left leg, in this case, is going to be her base as she lifts up and extends the right leg back and off the floor once more. Okay, now to add a little bit more for the balance effort here, she's going to extend her left arm forward. Good. Breathe. Good. Left arm goes to the floor underneath left shoulder. Right knee comes into forehead. Forehead to right knee. And now the right knee floats to the floor in front of the left. And lower back. Extended child's pose for a breath or two. And then when she's ready, the next in-breath lifts her up. And the right leg becomes her base. Her left leg extends back. And now the right arm extends forward for further balance. Great. Beautiful. Good. Couple more breaths. And now right hand goes to the floor, left knee to forehead, forehead to left knee. And she sets the left knee down again in sort of that off-kilter state and sits back. All right, now we want to go up side body a little bit here. So the next aspect we're going to do is starting the same, right? As you pull off your heels, now left knee is going to be your base. Extend the right leg straight back and off the floor. Good. Now, externally opening that right leg, so she's going to roll away and swing the right leg out to the right and plant it into the floor. Pressing off with her hands, now the upper body is going to lift up towards the ceiling. Good. There we go. Exhale, right hand goes down, right leg. Left arm comes up and over for the moment. Just opening left side. You notice her toes on her right foot are into the floor, but what she's doing is reaching the outside edge of that right foot into the floor by lifting the arch on her right foot to firmly secure that leg to the floor as she works with it. Now, if she wants to open up a little bit more on the left side, she can just let the left hand just hang over her head, right? And just hang there and open up a little bit more into the armpit area. Good. Okay, nice deep in breath now. As she exhales, that left arm's going to go all the way to the floor outside her left hip. And the right arm is going to continue that line of energy up her right leg and out over her right hand. And there we go. And breathe for this supported side plank. Two, three, good. Upper body lifts back up. Sweep the arms up towards the ceiling, interlace the fingers, press the palms up. But as the palms go up, the shoulder blades are pulling down to create space around neck. Good. Good. Next in breath, steps the right foot forward into a low lunge. There you go. Good. So start taking that right knee forward of the right ankle just a little bit. Good. And start to lengthen out that left thigh a little bit. Good. Upper body. As in all our practice, ha and ta energy is always at work. So one part of the body moving one way, another part moving another way to create opening. So she takes the right knee forward. The upper body is going up and back slightly into a back bend. Good. A couple more breaths here. And then on the exhale, the hands go down to the floor. Right leg goes back to meet the left leg in tabletop position. And lower down to extended child's pose for a moment. Take a couple breaths here. All right, in breath now. As she lifts off her heels, the left leg extends back and off the floor. Good. Externally rotates away from the floor, and then the left leg sweeps out and brings itself into the floor to the left. As she pushes off with her hands, her upper body lifts up. Exhale, left hand goes down the left leg as the right arm reaches up and over and starts opening up the right side. Breathe. Each exhale, an opportunity maybe to open a little bit more by allowing that left hand to slide down. Right, the left foot a little bit more. Good. Now we didn't show this on the right side, but on this side's a possibility here. You can take the toes of the left foot and bring them up towards the ceiling, so you'll be balancing on your left heel. Okay, there you go. And you can probably go down a little bit more with that left hand when you were able to do that. And she's already allowed the right arm to bend over her head here and opening up armpit area and a more length of the right side of the body. Good. A couple more breaths. Good. And then she lifts up. In breath, exhale. Now the right hand goes to the floor, left hand goes over, and it's a continuation right there of the left leg, the energy up the left leg and the left side and out through the left fingertips. Breathe. Good. Press the palms up as the shoulder blades go down the back. Good. A couple more breaths here. And then when she's ready, the left foot will come forward into a low lunge. So stepping that left foot forward. Good. Starting to sink right into that right quadricep in front of the thigh. Upper body now is lifting up and creating a slight back bend as she's reaching back. But the left knee keeps coming forward. Good. A couple more breaths. Good. Hands going down to the floor now, supporting that low lunge. Both feet go back right to tabletop position. Okay. Just give a little cat arch and dog tilt situation in your spine just to come back to neutral. Get a little equilibrium here. Now we're going to ask for a little bit more. This requires a little bit of strength. So if it's not right for you at this point, then you don't have to go here yet, but we'll have Gabby do it because, hey, she's strong. Turn the toes under on her feet, right? And we call this the runner's crouch. So what's going to happen is she's going to press the front of the mat or the rug away from her as she lifts her knees up into her diaphragm. Good, and presses back. There you go. She's also doing a great job right here of pulling her shoulder blades away, her shoulders away from her neck by using the muscles underneath her shoulder blades to pull that back. Good. Now we ask for a little bit more side work. So what will happen is she'll pivot on her the balls of her feet, sending her heels towards the left and her knees in towards the right. At the same time now, she'll walk the right hand forward. Good. Now this really opens up the right side. Now it's time to breathe even more. Good. 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 And now pivot back to center, pull the hand back, and obtain the same thing on the other side, sending knees into the left and heels right, and then walking the left hand forward and breathing right up the left side, expanding that area. Good, and once more back to center, and letting the knees gently drop to the floor, arching the back into a cat arch, and sending yourself back to the extended child's pose, taking the pressure off the shoulders for the moment. Alright, as the next in-breath comes in, you lift off your heels, extend the right leg straight back and off the floor once more. Now we ask you to bend that right leg. Lift the right knee away from the floor as high as you can. Okay, keep bending that right leg. And now open the pelvis up to the right and take the right foot almost like you want to touch the back of your left shoulder with it. And reach. That's it. There we go. Good, good. Good. Now as she exhales, bring that knee to forehead, forehead to knee, arch the back to counter the back bend that you just did. And bring that knee to the floor right in front of the left knee, about 3 inches or so. Good. Settle in, extend left leg straight back and off the floor. Bend the left leg. Okay. Open pelvis now up to the left and reach that left foot as much as you can. Not only are you lifting, but you're reaching, right, for the outside edge of that right shoulder. Good. Good. And on the exhale, left knee comes into forehead, forehead to left knee. Good. And once more, place that knee to the floor in front of the right and extend now the right leg again. Now we're going to do the same thing here. So she's going to bend. She's going to lift. She's going to open the pelvis and reach. But we'll add one more little goodie to this, right? So what I want her to do is to sweep that right foot all the way around in front of her left leg and put it into the floor without touching it. Okay, got it? Good. Once she's there, now the left leg extends back and off the floor, and she does it again very deliberately and reaches it around, first opening up the front. Good, and then collapsing as she brings it all the way around and in front of the right leg and down. Okay, one more time each side. That's it. And all the way around, perfect. Nice. And left leg same. Good, and reach. And all the way around. Now, I'm gonna have her stop here and spread her feet apart, right? Good. Now, as she exhales, she sits down in between the legs, right? There we go. Okay, now usually we do a pose called Gamukhanasana cow face here, but we're gonna do a little different today. So I want her to sweep her arms up towards the ceiling and cross now. So she's got her left leg on top of right. So right arm's going to cross now in front of left, and back around. Okay, there we go. In breath, the arms up once. Exhale, down into the chest. So this is Garudasana Eagle Pose with the hands. In breath up. Exhale, down. Once more, in breath and up. Exhale and down. Now this last one is in breath and up. All right, and now she's going to reach back with her hands in this position, back towards the back of her head, opening. Okay, front chest, armpit area, just a little bit more. Breathe. Good. Good. Now as she exhales, she's going to lower and go into a forward fold, allowing her hands to float forward, over in the front. Good. now is to pull off your seat and up onto your knees. So pulling forward and up, there you go. Now that right leg comes all the way around, so extend it back and off. Alright, then bend, okay, open, and now float all the way around in front of the left thigh. And the same thing happens, the feet open, and she sits back in between. Good. Now with the right leg on top, the left arm goes up first, right arm goes underneath and back around, and we do the same three times. Up once, and down, twice, and down, and three times, and down, and the fourth time is up, and reaching back behind you. Good. Two, three, and now floating forward and just laying down on top of the thigh and releasing. This time now the in-breath brings her up and her feet part and the bottoms of the feet come together in a bottom konasana position. Okay, good. Hands now just outside your hip width, just behind your shoulders, right? So now the idea is to push up and open the chest. The exhale is to bend slightly and just shrink into this, right? In-breath and up. Exhale and close. The bottom edges of the feet now are pressing in against one another and into the mat as best you can. Good. Then it's an in-breath and up. And the exhale is a gentle Rishi twist, taking her left knee over on top of her right. Good. Good. Take a couple more breaths. Good, and then back to Baddha Konasana or Cobbler Pose. Another in-breath here. Exhale, simple Rishi twist to the other side as the right knee comes over on top of the left. Breathe. Good. In-breath back to Baddha. Exhale, Rishi twist one more time. Now the next in-breath brings that left foot to the outside of the right thigh, just above the right knee. She may want to tuck in this right foot just a little bit for a base here. Okay. Taking another in-breath here, right arm goes up towards the ceiling. And then as she exhales and moves into a further twist here, she brings that right elbow to the inside, right, of the left leg, pressing elbow or tricep against thigh, thigh against tricep as she presses in with left hand and really attempts to straighten her spine as much as she can into the twist. Center once more, stacking left knee on top of right. There you go. Exhale into a forward fold here. Sweeping the arms around behind her back, now interlacing your fingers and lifting the arms up towards the ceiling as your shoulder blades come together and breathe. Good. Her up now, resting back on her arms so that she can release that left leg back into Baddha Konasana position once more. Take another in-breath and lift. Exhale, shrug forward, collapse. In-breath up. Exhale and release. Once more, up. And now right leg comes over on top of left Rishi twist. And right foot goes to the outside of the left thigh. right arm lifts up and back. Exhale, left arm inside. Back to center. Okay, and she drops now her right knee on top of the left. Moves into a forward fold over that top leg, and when she's ready, sweeping her arms around, drawing her shoulder blades together, interlacing fingers and lifting the arms up away from her back as she draws her shoulder blades together. Breathing here. She comes, the hands flow back, she turns back to center, brings the bottoms of her feet together once more. In breath and exhale. And in breath, now the arms float up towards the ceiling, interlace the fingers, smooth the shoulders just a little bit more by pressing the palms up. And then taking the left elbow and reaching it out to the left before dropping the hands behind the head. And then floating that right elbow over to the right before you lift up to center. So now you begin just a gentle shoulder sort of mini flow within our flow. Three or four times one way, and then three or four times the other way, trying to keep the palms pointing up towards the ceiling. Good. Good. And then release the arms down to the floor as she extends her legs now, so push back a little bit. There we go. Hands just outside the hips now, Dandasana Sat Pose. Extend out through the heels for a moment, opening up the backs of the legs by that extension. Good. Then point the toes and open up the front of the feet. Good. Good. With the toes pointed now, lift hips into a reverse plank. Now walk the feet back so that your heels are right underneath your knees. Reverse tabletop. Good. Good. Alright. Now we do a movement that's just gonna throw the blood up a little bit more. It's called the swing. She's going to straighten her legs and let her hips float back between her arms. Good. There you go. And then float back up to the reverse tabletop. Good, about two or three more times. Good. And back up. Back. And once more. Good. Now instead of going back between the arms, she's just going to sit straight down, keeping her knees bent. Take another in-breath and extend the arms forward. Exhale, dropping chin into chest. She's going to arch the back and lean back and catch her shins at that last bit of the exhale. And in-breath, pull herself forward. And up. Okay, a couple more times. Catch the shins. There you go. And then in breath, pull up. Good. Once more. Lower back. And pull. Good. Now the next time she goes down, she's going to bring her knees with her all the way to the floor. Good. Bring your knees into your chest. Give yourself a hug here. Good, now just rock side to side, massage out the spine a little bit, and as you rock your knees to the right or to the left, your head goes in the opposite direction, keeping a little bit of a twist happening. Good. Good. Good, let the arms float down to your side, bring your feet into the floor, keep your knees bent. Okay, baby bridge pose, presses in with your feet. Lifts the hips away from the floor. Good. Good. Like your thighs are spinning inward, almost like you're holding a block in between. As you exhale, slowly lower down from shoulders to smaller backs. You kind of round your back as you go down. Once the sacrum touches, the knees come into the chest once more, and you counter the back bend. Right, do this sort of back the skin folding action here. Good. Once more, baby bridge pose, feet into the floor, pressing in, lifting the hips away from the floor. Good. Now see if she can walk her hands underneath her back and interlace her fingers. Shoulder blades coming together. She's trying to reach her hands up in between her heels if she could, right? Good. That's it. Walk feet back about another step towards, right, your hands. Good. Now see if you can take the heels off the floor and lift. Good. All right. Release your hands now from the interlace. Take your right arm back alongside your head. So you're going to reach it back. There you go. Good. And now the same with the left. Excellent. Breathe. Slowly lower the heels down. Slowly lower from shoulders to small of back. The arms come forward alongside, and once more, the knees come into the chest and you hug. Good. Bring forehead to knees, knees to forehead. Excellent. There we go. Good. Now, as you let your head float down to the floor, bring your elbows close to your side, but keep them bent so that they're at a right angle. Make fists with your hands. As your feet float to the floor now, bring them in baddha position, right? So baddha konasana. So again, here's an area that I want you to keep aware of here, right? Because I'm going to ask Gabby to take some weight on her head a little bit. So as she presses in with her elbows, I want her to arch her back, lift her chest up towards the ceiling and scoop to the top of her head. There you go. That's it. Good. Now, there's a couple more steps that takes this a little bit more and a couple steps of difficulty. So just be careful. Now, if she can, I want her to bring her hands to namaste on her chest. Good. This takes a lot of pressure on the top of the head, so keep your elbows next to you if this doesn't feel right for you. Allow the knees to relax and float out, opening up the groin a little bit more. And now possibly extend the arms back alongside your head. You're fully open here, so you need to take advantage of your breath and breathe as much as you can, fully, deeply, evenly. Good, and now the elbows come back alongside and into the floor to release off the top of your head. Good. Good. Take another in-breath, knees come together. Exhale into your chest and hug. Good. Now arms float out shoulder level into the floor. Gentle twist brings the knees to the right to the floor. The gaze goes to the left. And we'll find that right foot and bring it out on top of the left knee, holding yourself into the pose just a little bit and opening up left side and moving into the twist. Good. And then the in-breath brings her back to center, knees into chest and hug. And then to the other side for the twist. As the arms float out, knees flow up left, gaze goes right. And then she hooks it in with her left foot on top and breathe. The in-breath back to center, knees into chest and hug. Now send arms and legs straight up towards the ceiling. Using core strength now, all right, you're going to let the legs float forward into the floor as the arms float back alongside your head all the way to the floor. So all the way back. There you go. Once the legs have touched the floor and the arms are onto the floor alongside your head, take one more opportunity to kind of reach out through fingertips, out through toes and heels and feet, right? Or get as much length, right, in this particular posture as possible. And then to open up left side a little bit, we'll take and walk the heels over to the right So walking the legs over to the right, and the arms are going to follow, except you're going to keep the shoulder blades and your backside into the floor and breathe. Good. And then back to center, walking everything back to starting position. Then over to the left. Breaths. And then walk back to center once more. Once she finds her next in breath, she'll walk the knees into her chest one more time. Bringing forehead to knees, knees to forehead. Good. See if she can reach her arms around and hold on to her elbows in front of her shins. Really tighten the ball. Good. Now, as she lowers her head to the floor, the arms are going to float out shoulder level, and the feet will come into the floor with the knees bent. Okay, arms out shoulder level, feet into the floor. All right, now, I'm trying to support the knees on their own, so what I'd like her to do is to walk the feet away outside her hip width. So you're leaning the knees inward, the feet are out. There you go. Good. The next movement is to take the left arm across your chest to your right, and your right arm across your chest to your left. Okay. So essentially, she's not doing anything, requiring any muscle to kind of hold her there. She's lying her arms on top of her chest. She's leaning the knees against one another. This is what we call the constructed rest pose. Sort of the spot just before we go into our shavasana for the practice. So this is where there's a transition from the doing of the practice, which she's been at for the last half hour or so, into the not doing part of the practice. Okay. Again, the ha and ta aspects, all right, that are facilitated in just about any yoga practice, hatha yoga practice that you do. I'm going to take this moment here for her awareness to walk or to glide throughout her body and see what's been going on, what's happened, what parts have been accessed that are drawing their attention to her. Good. Stay here for a few more breaths. Time, she'll let the arms float to her side, palms up, and extend the legs out in front of her, all right, for final relaxation and shavasana. Thank you. needs to wait for a sign, she said, before I did anything. And one night I had a dream and an angel in black tights came to me and said, you know, you can start any time now. And I asked, is this a sign? And the angel started laughing and I woke up. Now I know the whole world is filled with signs, but if there's no laughter, I know they're not for me. Remember, even after all this time, the sun never says to the earth, you owe me. Look what happens with a love like that. Lights the whole sky. Slowly now, remember when coming out of Shavasana, don't be in a hurry. Take your time, remember to spend some time on your side in that fetal position before rising to a seated. Everybody for joining us today in practice, and as is the tradition in our practice, I'd like you all to join us with three rounds of that sacred syllable Om, that energy that is the beginning and the end. So together, nice deep in breath. May all beings in all planes of existence realize peace. Om Shanti, peace. Namaste.